This is just a little bit of the end of my day. I started off with a little bit of cardiovascular work and active release therapy and stretching with the bands that you'll see later on in the video. I'm just doing a little bit of freestyle posing where I'm just listening to the music, trying to go through different classic poses. I'm getting ready for my competition coming up. Posing and feeling the beat and understanding the transition in posing is very important. If you're interested in learning how to pose or how to construct a posing routine, nutritional information, or any other aspects of getting in contest shape or athletic shape, you can contact me on my website, www.lgfitnessmessiah.com. Enjoy the rest of the video. Thanks.
Between you and the chimpanzee. The DNA difference is only 1.23%. 1.23% is not much of a difference, is it? Physiologically, the difference between you and the chimpanzee is only 1.23% in the DNA content. But in terms of intelligence and awareness, we are phenomenally different from a chimpanzee. So you have an intelligence for which you don't have a stable enough base. This is your intelligence which is talking to you right now. If we take off a part of the stomach, what kind of rubbish is that? Who has been trying to the whole thing on it? Very hesitant being. He started checking at the top. I low on the very first day he reached the top of the first practice day. Within a fortnight he reached the top of the practice. Just sitting on the topmost branch of the tree, beginning to enjoy the scenery. The old farmer who was rocking in the rocking chair saw a fat old man on the top of the tree, put on his shotgun and shot the bird off. The moral of the story is, many times, good things can get you to the top, but it never lets you stay there.
Stadia all along the coast, 1 kilometer inside, sat there and watched the damn thing coming, isn't it? Yes, sir. Such a great event. Such an absolutely beautiful event. But because we are senseless in such a tsunami by itself is not a tragedy. Even human ignorance is always a tragedy.
Thank you. some of the more modern, I guess, philosophers, like, understanding how it's like suffering is just part of life. Or Scott Beck are saying, suffering is part of life, we should suffer. They're saying, no, it's not necessary. So, can you maybe expound on that a little bit?
Suffering human beings have to celebrate the suffering.
What else would they have?
Buddha did not say, life is suffering. He's trying to tell you that the way to live beyond suffering, isn't it? He's telling you right now, most people are existing in such a way that life is suffering. But the very reason why he's teaching you something is to tell you that there's another way to live, isn't it? We don't know what kind of miserable human being he was. So we need to understand this. People are coming to conclusions by looking at